Okay, now that we got her recorded, the time is 1:03. So let's go ahead and call our meeting to order. I'll get that on our deal here, 1:03. First off, welcome everybody. Derek, welcome as the kind of new guy. You were with us last meeting. You'll be taking over, and Rocky is retired. Had a nice party. I wished I could have been there instead of at a funeral, but that wasn't going to happen. So I hope it all turned out good. Rocky seemed to have enjoyed himself.
Yes, he did enjoy it. I did actually send him the link for this one if he had an opportunity. So.
Oh yeah, that's great. Love to have him. Lindsay, welcome.
Thank you.
You're the next new guy. We'll get to you with a report here a little later in the meeting. But again, welcome to our group.
Appreciate it. Thank you.
Yeah. Everyone should have a copy of all of the information that Derek sent out. Our first order of business is approval of the minutes from last month's meeting. And I think... yes, we have a copy of that.
Here, I'll go ahead and share my screen.
Oh, okay. That'd be great.
All right. Y'all seeing that?
Yes.
All right.
The minutes from last meeting, which was December the 3rd, should have a copy of that as you see it there. Any comments on that? If not, I'll entertain a motion to approve the minutes.
I'll make a motion. Well, I'm there. So.
I'll second that motion.
Okay. We have a motion and a second to approve the minutes from December 3rd. All in favor, aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Okay. Minutes are approved. Old business. We had talked last month about the DOLL working on the new licensing software and all of that. And Derek, you mentioned that. A little early before we started, that is going to at least go live for testing and I assume live for actual input tomorrow.
Is that correct, Lindsay?
Yeah, you know, whenever you guys are ready for me to go on and on about it, I can kind of give you a brief rundown of what's going on, what's taking place, and what our steps are to get it pushed out between now and Monday.
Mm-hmm.
Is this the appropriate time in your meeting to go ahead and do that, or you want to do it on a new business, or how would you like to handle it?
We'll wait until your report comes up later.
Okay, that'll be fine.
That'll be fine. I just we had it as a line item, so I wanted.
It's going to be the primary discussion today.
Okay, that'll be great.
Yeah, I'll bring my office over when it comes time, so they can hear you what you got to say about it.
Okay.
There you go. Moving on to new business, the first item we have is election of officers. That's one of the first things we do in our January meeting every year. I will open the floor to any nominations for the offices that are open, and that is chairman and vice chairman. And I think those are the ones that we select.
I'd like to make a motion to nominate Richard Garcia as chairman.
Okay.
I'll second.
Okay. Obviously, we can't vote, but we have a motion and a second to retain myself as chairman. In favor, aye.
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 Opposed? Okay. Done. Vice chair, is presently is Roger. So I'll right. open the floor for vice chair nominations.
I'd like to make a motion to nominate Roger Chapel as our vice chair.
I'll second.
Okay. We have a motion and a second for Roger to remain as the vice chair as he is now. All in favor? Aye.
Aye.
Opposed? None. Let its record show that he is has been approved to be vice chair. Technically, Roger, I know that we've had Harry as your follow-up second. If you couldn't make it for some reason, is that still reasonable?
Yeah, I believe so.
Okay. All right.
As long as I think in person it is, I don't believe he doesn't do all the newfangled, you know, he doesn't go to the newfangled meetings and on Zoom, you know, he's done one or two, but he didn't care for him.
Yeah. Well, it would be a strange situation if both you and I couldn't do the meeting and we'd have to fall back. That would be a pretty, pretty drastic situation, but in the past, we have just unofficially sort of set that up because Harry's been involved with us for so long. Okay.
Are we going back in person anytime soon, Derek, or do you know?
Well, basically, that was just kind of left up to each particular committee. You know, of course, you know, Jack definitely was wanting to come up here and do in person, but, you know, we can discuss it with y'all. I know the other committees, you know, most of them, you lose some. Most. If he's having some issues. Can you hear me, Roger?
Technical difficulties.
Oh.
The heck?
We can see you and hear you.
Mm-hmm. Okay, I can see you and hear you now too. I don't know what happened.
But basically, the other committees, it didn't seem like anybody was really just ready to go on coming back up here. And basically, Cody just said we weren't going to get a meeting room for just one person to come up here. He wasn't going to hold a room out for that. So, you know, now if y'all want to come this way, as far as I know, that would not be an issue. And I'm sure we could get Jack to come at that point. But, you know, we just kind of still leaving that up to the committees to decide that at this point in time.
Okay.
I'll wait till everybody else feels safe. I mean, right now, I think we're going through I think there's a lot of people getting sick right now. You know, it's coming in like the flu, and I know quite a few people right now that are sick, so maybe wait until after flu season to see what happens.
Yeah, our from an engineering perspective, our next real meeting, if you will, is going to be in April. So everything prior to that right now is all going to be by Zoom or Microsoft Meetings or something, not face-to-face. So I think that's just playing it safe. We probably could, but we'll have people from all over the state coming, and we just think it's too risky for everyone. So I'm with you, Roger. I think let's consider Zoom again next month, and if we do find that cases have gone down and things are looking better, you know, maybe later here in the spring we could start getting back together again in person.
I think people like it. Sounds about right.
Yeah, I think that's the safest thing to do. Second item, you should have a copy of our mission statement. The only thing I know that has changed really with that is because of some of the change in legislation and the committees falling under different department names and things, there have probably been a few name changes in it, but essentially it says the same thing that we've all signed into for years now. Derek, we do need to sign this and get a signed copy to you. Is that correct?
Yes, that's how I feel about it. I feel like we should be having signed copies up here.
Okay.
So at least that way we have any official documentation in case they ever start looking in on anything.
Sure. What I would suggest is that each of you sign your respective copy on your respective line, make a PDF of that, and send it to Derek, and
yep,
and he can compile all of those.
Yeah, I'll put it all in one folder.
In one folder, and I think that will suffice for it, as long as we get the signatures in place. While we're talking about that, if you'll roll back to the bottom of that one. Derek, yeah, there we go. We'll need to get with Jack to get him to sign his copy. So we might need to just send him an email and be sure that he knows to sign that copy and get it to you, Derek. The other thing that we were talking about before we started the meeting, you notice we have a non-voting member and that slot's vacant. In the past, we have had someone in that position. It's been a few years ago, but the position went vacant. It's not a voting member, but I'd kind of like to see if we couldn't get someone to come in and be our non-voting member and represent something at large, whether it's schools, the press, someone from industry.
Jack had a lawyer that he said was wanting to fill the position before the COVID hit. I don't know if he still has that guy or not, but
okay.
He thought a lawyer would be good because we have been sued before, and he said a lawyer would probably help prevent that. You know.
Yeah.
I don't know. If anybody knows somebody that would be a good fit.
Yeah. I was telling Derek, Laura used to come to our meetings every month. But absolutely, I'm open to suggestions. I just wanted to throw it out there to everyone to, if you've got some thoughts on it. It is a non-voting member. If you have some ideas, let's get them to Derek. Derek can compile that, and that will be an agenda item that we'll put on old business for next month's meeting, and we'll see if we can come to a consensus on someone to maybe fill that position.
Get it here. We've been in discussions about this with the other committees as well on some spots that had not been filled. So I pulled up the law for our SEAC meeting or committee. And it basically says the Career Education and Workforce Development Board shall appoint a state electrical apprenticeship committee consisting of the seven members, et cetera. So it seemed like there was a little bit of, going back and forth on, could the committee actually do this, or does this actually need to be coming from this board? So we were going to get some clarification on that. So that way we would know if that's something that you as the committee could do, or is that something that maybe, hey, we get a recommendation from y'all, and then I pass it on up the line to Cody and so forth. So, sure. So we'll be getting some clarification on that, and then I can get that to y'all at the next meeting.
Sure. That sounds good, Derek. That's why I thought we'd just get some names to you and let you
mm-hmm.
The bureaucracy from the other end, be sure we dot our I's and cross our T's correctly. So
yes.
Good. The third item is stipend and travel. I think everyone had gotten a W-9 and hopefully filled that out and sent that in. So where do we stand with that, Derek?
So I was going to ask everybody. I only got one of them. You're the only one.
Okay.
I mean, as far as it sent one in to me. So
I got mine, but I'm
okay.
Busy. I'll send it in with this signed copy.
Okay, that'd be fine. So I was just going to bring it up to y'all so y'all can get it in and we can get it. I can get it turned in and everything. I know the other ones were, you know, looking at, you know, $50 per meeting. And if we do get to where we start traveling again, they'll give y'all 42 cents a mile.
Okay.
Oh. On that email where you shared that, I printed it off. Does it have an address that we can mail that to? I don't want to email.
I will. After we get done, I'll email y'all our address, and then y'all can just mail it in.
Sounds great.
All right.
I sent one, but I don't know what happened to it.
Okay.
I'll send another, though.
Who did you send it to, Charles?
Is a signed PDF, Derek? Is that acceptable?
Yes.
It is. Okay.
I mean, as long as it's a PDF, we'll take it. I mean, it looks like all the other ones that I've seen come in the past look like they probably are not, you know, the accurate ones.
Okay. That sounds good. Moving on to our experience credit, we have two tabled items from last month. The first one was Christopher St. Nicholas.
Rick, I think we need y'all to go ahead and, you know, take a vote and okay the stipend. It's one of those things that we can't change or anything. But we still just need it, you know, y'all to okay whatever the state rate basically would allow.
Okay. And as you said, generally the state rate is $50 for the meeting and 42 cents a mile for travel.
Correct.
Which it has been. So, okay. Based on that, I'll entertain a motion to approve a stipend of $50 per person per meeting for our committee meeting and a reimbursement of 42 cents a mile for travel mileage associated with our board meeting. I'll open the floor for a motion to that effect.
I'll make a motion to accept the stipend as stated.
Okay.
Second that motion.
Okay. We have a motion and a second to accept the $50 stipend and the 42 cents a mile for travel. All in favor, aye.
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 All opposed? Okay. Motion passes. If you can do whatever your magic is, Derek, on your end.
Okay.
Something we need to sign to that effect besides the W-9, just let us know.
Okay. All right.
All right.
It took 22 years.
Yeah. It took y'all long enough to get something, I think.
22 years.
No, I don't think so. We got a tax break. So that's a good thing. Okay. We'll look at that first experience credit then. Christopher St. Nicholas. We had asked for a year and a half, and we had tabled it for more information from for last month. Have we gotten
so I did speak with Christopher after our last meeting a week or so after that. Kind of broke it down for him and told him exactly the form that Navy CE 5635, which is stated in our SEAC guidelines, as far as what is being required, and told them, hey man, that's what I need. I need something, something with this number on it. So he said he would take a look, but I have not heard from him since.
Okay. Okay.
Y'all. Yeah, I was looking at the SEAC guidelines. I don't really see anything in there where it's very specific about once it gets to our committee, how long that we have to for sure, go. And then at one point we finally cut it off. So
right.
I think y'all just been going on 3 months in the past. Is that correct?
Right. What we've done is if we don't get any information after 3 months, then we simply pass on it and let it drop.
Gotcha.
So we have been getting information from him. Mm-hmm. Obviously, it's the government, and
I'm sure it might take a little while.
They have their own way of doing things. So as long as he is aware of that, mm-hmm. let's continue to keep it on the experience deal. But you know, by another couple of months, if we haven't heard anything from him, we will drop it.
Well, if you want me to, I will, you know, get back in touch with them and let them know, hey, we really need to have something hopefully by, you know, this time next month.
Yeah.
Because I know the school also at that time will be wanting to get this so they know what to do.
Sure, they're eyeing on it as well. And I hate holding him up, but I hate holding the school up too.
Right.
Okay. Then Jerry Williams, we were looking for an affidavit or something from.
Mm-hmm. Yes. I talked to Sherry on the 20th and informed her of, you know, the affidavit, kind of walked through this paperwork that we did have, you know, telling her, hey, we don't really have an affidavit from that notarized affidavit from that employer.
Yeah.
So after looking through it, she understood what I was saying. So she was going to be getting back with them to try to get that, you know, sent over and put out. So hopefully, you know, by the time we get to next month, she'll have that.
Okay. If everyone is agreeable, let's go ahead and table that one, you know, as well, since they have been informed. But if we don't see something this next month, then I think we would be within rights, given as old this one goes back to October. You know, to try to go ahead and drop it if we can't get an affidavit. Okay. Well, those two are continuing to be tabled. We'll move on to reports. We've got some information here, some good looking numbers, really, from I'm not sure whether
here we go.
Is this
these are from Randy.
From Randy.
Now I didn't hear nothing from him. I assumed he was going to be here. Didn't hear nothing. Something must have came up or something.
Okay.
But I had just went ahead and took his numbers and broke them down on a sheet where we could actually see them a little bit better.
Okay.
So.
Yeah, I thought these were Randy's numbers, and I just was just going to see if there were any comments or anything that went along with them. Comments here.
122 active received programs.
Yes.
Wow.
Yep. 122 active programs as of the 1st of December. We're at 383 new apprentices. That's up 90. We total was 7,399. We had dropped 23. 22 had been suspended. That was up 18. Canceled 335. I guess that says that was up 49, and we have completed 91.
These numbers will be substantially different next month after tomorrow.
Yeah.
Yeah, I was going to say this probably does not reflect all the paperwork that's laying on desks right now.
Right. Yeah, I'd say that's just as of whenever he probably that right around after 1st of December.
Okay.
We got 741 employers. Then we go down here. And then here's our, you know, our construction, IT, medical, manufacturer, other. As far as either new or completed, you know, per trade there broke down. Because the construction does plumbing, electrical, et cetera. Mm-hmm. Then the other ones are more specific.
Yeah, I was going to ask on the active programs, what all that includes, if it's electrical and plumbing or if it's...
Yes, I'm pretty sure that includes all active apprenticeship schools that we have in the state.
Okay.
That would include cooking and baking and...
Yes, yeah, our miscellaneous trades are, and then our plumbing and electrical.
Interesting. And our unemployment rate continues to go down.
Yeah.
We're down to what, 3.4% now? Something, I think that was the last number I saw. We're well below national average.
We're well below zero here. We can't find anybody to work.
Yeah. Yeah.
Sad.
Yeah, it is. I had a young man who was overseeing the crew putting the roof on my house was asking me about wanting to, go in the trades. He didn't want to supervise a group of roofers all his life. Nothing wrong with that, but he wanted to get into a real trade. And he asked me how to get started in the electrical apprenticeship program. So I advised him on that. I want my roof finished first. But, I told them opportunities are out there, particularly where you are, Roger. They're just, crying for people. Lots of work.
Yeah, like I told you before, I've got guys that are starting out apprentices that they're going into the ditch over at Walmart today, and they will graduate school before they get out of the ditch. So,
man. Yeah,
well, they got 4 years of, they're putting in these tunnels and putting in the underground for that campus over there. And they'll be in the mud for the first 4 years.
Man, well, that's a hard way to go, but
I mean, yeah. There. That's just crazy.
Wow. Well, I hope I hope the trend continues for us and to stay ahead of the rest of the nation as far as that goes. I think we're doing a heck of a job with our schools and our young folks here in the state, getting them employed, getting them educated in the trades. So congratulations to the schools, and look forward to seeing this new program coming online. So with that, we'll go ahead and turn the floor over to you, Lindsay, to talk about the new program that's coming online tomorrow.
Hold on a second. Hey, Sherry, you'll probably want to hear this.
Okay. And mine's expired. Gotta get real, I guess.
Yeah. I think you're muted there, Lindsay.
I hit on mute, but it didn't. Again, Rick, thank you, and thanks everyone for having me today. We're no exception to the employment things that you guys are speaking of, because one of the guys that I need badly is sitting in the center square here in my Hollywood Squares pictures in front of me, Derek. And right now we're down to one inspector, Travis, and I don't think he even speaks to me anymore. So I don't know what's going on there. But
I know Travis. I've worked with him over the years, and
yeah,
I understand.
Yeah, he's doing everything he can, and it's not enough for five people to be able to do right now, I tell you.
You got more inspectors coming?
Well, I'm still trying to get my chief through all the administrative stuff. It's a matter of being able to compete with wages, and that's the state's woefully shy and trying to work on it, trying to get some proposals out there. We'll see how that goes. It's one step at a time. I've had an open administrative specialist for this program open for 10 months. I've hired four people and they have yet to show through the door. And I've just hired my fifth one. I'm banking on her showing up a week from Monday. And that kind of leads me into why, you know, some of the reasons we're going to this automated online system, one for the, to make it a little faster, a little better for everyone, and give the schools some controls where we were probably missing things in the past. The licensing, we're going to roll it out. It's going to official publish sometime tomorrow to be available to use. I'm telling everyone Monday. I'm going to be sending out a demo video to the schools. And with that in mind, Eric, I've got a email list that Rocky provided me. And when I sent out the first initial email blast, I got a lot of those returned. I don't know if y'all have got a cleaned up one or one that is a little more current, because I want to get this information out.
Okay.
The demo video is by our provider, which is NIC, INA, or everyone probably knows it as Arkansas.gov. We basically, what we're taking is the application to become an apprentice for our needs for licensing, and we're just making it an online form. Now, does it look the same as the form we're currently using? No, that's beyond IT's technical use. We've got some new required fields because of the laws that have been passed, whether, you know, there's the one-time waiver for licenses, if you meet certain poverty or assistance type of needs, that you can get a one-time license waiver fee. You've got to provide documentation. There's also, we're required to track the military, whether they're veterans or spouses of veterans. And these are things, some of these have been in place for a couple of years. Quite honestly, the forms were not updated and we hadn't been keeping our records. It was part of our audit findings as well. So that's going to add a few extra questions. The same principles are going to apply. When you fill out the form for an apprentice, you fill out it individually for each apprentice online, for each new apprentice. And what will happen, I'm hearing some feedback. Am I feeding back to you or is there someone else?
I'm good. Okay. Y'all good?
Okay. I'm sorry. It's probably on my end then. What will happen is that they will go in and create a user profile that basically goes into Arkansas.gov. That's for every person that does that. The school will set up the email addresses and everything for it to come back to them. That way, they will be able to manage the license. I know there's sometimes, and Derek, gentlemen, I'm not going to sit here and pretend I'm fluent on every aspect of this because I'm not. But we did see some instances where students were trying to work around the schools or try to get licenses approved, and they hadn't been cleared either through Derek's group or by the school's release. This puts the schools in more control of that on the release side of it. Mm-hmm. They're going to manage the license for them until they are cleared from apprenticeship to go on to become journeyman. And when they do, then they will release that profile to these individuals that's completed. And after that, they can manage their own license. The license will be mailed electronically back to the school for them to give to the apprentices. We are going to be an all digital platform, all digital licenses. Emails are required now. And as they become journeymen or masters or whatever field they become licensed in, they will receive their license on their cell phone. So it's what we've always done, but in a digital format. They'll pay online, they'll renew online, but we are letting the schools, you know, control some of these areas because from just what I've heard from some of the schools, and, you know, I don't particularly want to name names, but several of the schools in the state, this was one of the problems they expressed their concerns with. And so when we built the system, and Charles Covington at that time was real helpful on that, and he was part of the initial building of this. We built this into it so we could control less fraudulent activity. I don't want to call it fraudulent because sometimes people just don't know better. They really don't. But it's going to launch like I said, I've got to work this weekend. I'm going to send an email blast out to everyone with the video. We're not going to put it on our website because this is a demo video for the schools. It shows them what they can do, how they can control, and what they can do. The initial application will be out there. If they transfer to another school, they'll be able to, it's got a transfer form to kind of make it a portal for them to transfer it. It's also got a reinstatement form for those that leave and come back. Now, one of the things that's going to happen with that is that if they've been out of school longer than 5 years, our licensing platform will drop them off the list. So they'll have to come in and get a new license. If they reinstate within that 5 years, they'll maintain their same apprentice license. That's, you know, from what I'm getting interpretation, that's almost a statutory requirement anyway. We're not saying they can't have credit for the years that they did before that, because we looked to Derek and company to say they've got their hours in. But as far as keeping them an active license in the system after 5 years, it will kick them out. Of course, now we didn't do any apprentice license in the month of December, and we're taking a very generous, you know, liberal look because of that on the 30-day requirement of getting them licensed. When we kick this off Monday, hopefully everyone will have the video and watch it. It's 15 minutes long. This is, if you can type the first name, last name, the social, it's the same thing you've been writing, except you're typing. You will get the license back within, we're hoping within 12 to 24 hours. Again, I've got COVID and staffing issues right now, but our goal is right now, if we can get them back to the schools to hand to the apprentices within 24 hours, we're feeling good about it. Eventually we want to be able to have that. Our goal is to have that. If you do it at 8 a.m. by noon, they have that license. The only thing that, you know, they're going to have to provide us a rapids number, which they've always had to do. So however, that's going to fall into the play with Derek and his company, their group. We'll see how that works out. I'd just like to take questions if you guys have any for me.
Hey, Lindsay, this is Sherry. I have a question.
You don't look like Sherry.
Thanks. Yeah.
Sorry about that.
Thank God he doesn't.
Yeah. Go ahead, Sherry.
I have a question on release for tests. Are we going to be able to have access to creating their accounts and stuff for them to release them for their test?
Well, part of that is what we're waiting on. Derek and them are putting their system together. This is just the first phase. You know, I wanted to be able to do this all at once. We've been working with Rocky, and they're still, I talked to Derek, I think it was yesterday or the day before. They're still putting theirs together. The eventual goal is that when they're released from test, apprenticeships database, I'll talk to our database, in which is going to be in ELP and Arkansas.gov. When they get that release, then it moves right on. It'll be electronically done, which will expedite the process even farther. You know, a lot of this can be done without human hands, and human hands are in short supply anymore. That's part of the reason for going this. It wasn't the only one, but it was essentially, if we could do this and issue a license in an hour, which sometimes has taken a month, even when we were fully staffed, you know, it just makes sense to do.
Right. Okay.
Did I answer the question, or did I dance all around it like I tend to do?
Kind of danced around it, but I understand.
Yeah. The short answer is yes, and yes, we'll be able to get it done. We just got to put some of this together in pieces.
Well, we have such a large Hispanic region up here that some of our guys are not very good. They're not very computer literate. So they come into our office for us to release them for their tests. So we're having to upload it and everything anyways. So if we had access to where they didn't have to come in, we could just do it.
You'll be able to do that as long as you still control that account. Once you turn it over to them, once they've completed for tests, uh-huh, and you've released it, then we're going to have a process where you can just release them, give them their information. They go online and they'll change their account email. It's going to be based off their account email address. And then once it's released for test, then they'll go in and apply for their journeyman or what they want to do next. And you'll have control of that. We will not. Can we? Absolutely. If you come in, we'll be able to go in and make changes. But the release for test, till we get right now, we're still doing we got a little share file we do with Derek, plus we get some paper to follow it up. We're still doing that manually in the electronic system, if you will. We're uploading those documents. So we're going to be, once we can get Derek's database and our database talking, this will be automatic. That's my understanding, right, Derek?
That's kind of what I'm hearing. All that's this people working together.
I'm just waiting here for their IT people that they're ready to roll with their side of it.
Okay. Thank you.
Now, this is only going to be in the English language. There's no state mandate that we do bilingual.
Exactly.
And so
we have no mandate either.
Yeah. And so that's how that's going to be. That it's going to be an English thing until the legislature decides otherwise.
All right. I'm looking forward to getting this up and rolling.
Yeah. You should get, like I said, I was wanting to preview the video this afternoon when we started going through it. Some of the forms had apprentice misspelled, and we just thought that was kind of bad form that we couldn't even spell apprenticeship right. So they're reworking it. I should have a redraft of it in about 2 hours, and then I'm going to do the mass email.
Cool. Sounds great, Lindsay. Thank you.
Thank you, and I appreciate being here.
Any questions?
Sure. So, from my outside point of view, when can the schools start to use the system? Will they be notified that they can start clearing their desks of that paper tomorrow?
When I send the email out, the system, it's actually going to go live Saturday night. I'm saying 8 a.m. Monday morning start, because
okay,
you run into problems, we want to make sure we got some support there for you.
Right. Yeah, we were talking about that.
We were gonna work into Saturday and Sunday to get it done, but you know,
I get to. So that's to get this thing rolled out. Now, what we have done is we've already populated this with the existing apprentices. It's already going to be we've already migrated all the active apprentices or the active apprentices in the last 5 years are already in there. So they'll be able to go in and manage their accounts as well.
So that'll be on their permanent record.
Yeah. And what this is also going to do, from our side of it, and I'm looking for the benefits for us because, I need a benefit too, is so often we've run into, and Derek probably knows well, everyone calls us, where's my test record? Where's this? Where's that? All this documentation will be available to them online from now on in their individual confidential file. We're not going to control that. We're going to put the responsibility back where it needs to belong. You know, I get calls every day. People want to know their work history since 1957. You know, I don't know.
Yeah, we get calls. People want to know their attendance record. Now, first thing I say is, how many nights did you miss?
I have no idea. I hear you.
Go ahead. On creating a user profile for the licenses on these guys that say they drop out for 2 years and we're reinstating them, are we able to create them a user account to reinstate their license to renew it?
If they're in the last 5 years, what they'll do is they'll be able to come in and you'll be able to reinstate it. They're already in the system, Sherry. The only thing they'll have to do is probably catch up on their apprentice fees, their license fees.
Right. But we will be able to do that from here. They'll create them a username.
Right. You know, we've kind of built this system, let the schools and let those folks control it until they release them for testing. Then they'll take their own profile over to get their journeymans and masters. I don't want to name names, and I'm trying to pick. I talked to Karen over at NATF a bunch, and she explained that Mr. Fulmer Electric, talked to folks at Koontz. And some of the trade school, the union schools as well. And this was all their concern. So, we've kind of built that system to give them the control till they want to release the control.
Yes.
To the applicant. And that, I think that's what everyone wanted.
Yes. Okay. That's great. Cause that's what I like to have. So
you and my wife.
Thank you, Lindsay.
You bet. And if we're going to have, you know, this is a whole new system, whole new way of doing this. We're expecting over the first year when we launch renewals for journeymans, masters, and everything, about 35,000 to 40,000 phone calls. If you break that out at 5 minutes a call, you can see what we're going to be facing just in the phone calls. So it's going to be fun. But we're going to, you know, I've got, like I said, if she shows up, I got one other person coming on, and then I'm trying to work to get a couple of more positions created. But it's state government. Good luck. We're going to find a way. Now, right now I've got 9 staff members out with COVID right now. So everyone's being affected by it. Just so you'll know that if it may have any ancillary effect on you guys, yesterday our secretary limited access to any board meetings. They're all online, and we've kind of limiting visitor access as of yesterday.
How many staff do you have?
Well, I've got 5 programs. I've got about 33 people all together.
9 is substantial, then. That is so about a third almost.
It's a herd of cats, let me tell you. Our next move is to go with HVAC as far as our licensing program. Then we're going to go to elevator, then to boiler. HVAC, they've now got CEUs that they are going to do annually. They don't have a code cycle. They got their statute passed to be annually. I think that, and I'm already here and talk, they're trying to get a push for some sort of apprenticeship program in Arkansas. I know they've tried before. I don't know how it has been successful, but I'm hearing that there's some pretty strong talk about trying to run that next session, but I don't know. You guys may be more informed than I am.
I'm about HVAC.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, we need some meat in here, guys. So
I'm a big proponent of apprenticeship, not because I'm just playing to the hometown. I believe in it, in my heart. So
we have classes and apprenticeship schools out there now that do HVAC.
Black River over Hot Springs or over Garland County that has the actual apprenticeship program at the community college. I'm pretty sure.
Yeah, I'd have to look at it. I can't remember for sure. But, yeah, there is something. I think I know National Park over there does have something.
Right.
It's not required by law, though, is it?
Right.
No, but I'm hearing that that's what's going to happen now. You know, government is as government is. We'll see how it goes.
Yeah, we need some people that know what they're doing. That's for sure.
Yeah. Outside of that, gentlemen, what can I do to be of assistance to you to help you guys out? My time stretched thin, but I got to support the program to help support us as well.
I appreciate it.
Yeah, sounds good, Lindsay. This
we'll see if that's right in 30 days. We'll see if you say it sounds good in 30 days.
Yeah, well, it's a work in progress, but much appreciated. We have talked for years about getting some of the things that you're putting in place started. I'm tickled to see some of it getting going. It's just a tough time to be doing it.
And you know, as we go through this, outside of the statutory requirements, as we learn and grow from this, I guess we would say, I'm going to take input in, and if the apprenticeship group as a whole needs to see some changes or actions that we can do either through rule or through just making changes in the form. You know, we've got that flexibility to get that incorporated in. It'll be a work in progress. Like I said, we can start communicating electronic with Derek. At some point, I can see this being a license issued within an hour. It's probably a year away from that, but you feel if the school fills it out that morning within an hour, just depending on how fast the email flows, you'll have the license in the inbox to give the apprentice.
Good.
Sounds. That's it. Unless you got more questions.
No, that sounds good. I do have one. I'm just going to kind of throw out there with the legislative session and all. Do we think we're going to get approval of the new code? Electrical.
Okay.
Code?
Well, okay. That's a good question. It's been through. It's down at the governor's office right now. I don't. You know, so far we haven't hit any headwinds, is what I'll say. Our general counsel's out on extended medical leave right now. I expect her back in a week or two. You know, after that, then it's just a matter of having the public hearing,
right,
and getting it through the legislative committee. Our projected date was for March of this year. Then look, we're already getting ready. We got to start for the next code cycle.
Yeah.
What the only change that we've, you know, what the board actually focused on is, you know, we're a couple, three code cycles in the GFCIs, and we've always exempted those. They've removed that exemption, with the exception of with the AC units, because of the phase issuing, kicking those breakers out, arc fault breakers and everything. They did leave that out, much to the chagrin of a lot of contract electrical manufacturers that are selling breakers. If we have any problems, that's where it's going to be at, if the ABC or some of the other builders do it. But we're looking, a lot of the cities have already added that in on top of what we have exempted. We're not having the problems we had early on with them. So that's the only wait and see thing we have. We should have a public hearing on it. I'm hoping we'll call a special meeting of the board when that happens. And I'll certainly let Derek know to pass on, or any of you that want to get on our interested parties list, of the public hearing on it. I'm hoping to have that probably in the first or second week of February. And then I'm hoping to hopefully have a chief on and get our inspectors back up to speed to get those folks out there. But you know, 3.4% unemployment, and then the market for a master is pretty hot right now.
Yeah. I may put my tool belt back on.
Just to give you an example, I was working with the state of Montana there, you know, and I don't know they even have a two-story building in that state. They're paying $87,000 for an entry-level master inspector.
Oh, man.
And
well, I you know, from the engineering standpoint, it's a pretty thorny issue, for us as to what to design around. But from the other aspect, what code book are we supplying to now in the schools? Is it still law mandated version, or is it the new one, or
we're still teaching? We teach to the 2011 and 14 to pass the test, and then we teach the 17 and the 20, so you'll know them when they actually come into effect. But actually waiting to see how bad the 2023 looks. The 2020 was one, residentially speaking, was the hardest was the hardest hit code book since 1999.
Right. I was just wondering how far back we actually had to go.
We go back all the way to 11 to
wow. Okay.
Cover everything. But it's if they accept the new 2020 code, that will get us up to 2017, I think.
Right. Okay. I'm just curious how we're gonna handle that. So okay.
Test cycles fall behind, you know, the testing falls behind, but the and telling people that the stuff from 2005 is still relevant is actually gets hard to do, but it really is. You know, the every code was written was a law at one time, and they still all carries. They all still carry laws. So
Well, yeah. Good, Lindsay. Thanks so much. That was a great report. That sounds encouraging. I know you've got your work cut out for you, but But if there's anything that any of us can do to help you with feedback or any things like that, I can speak for the committee. We'd be glad to help you.
Well, thanks. And I do want the feedback more than the cussing, but I'll probably take a few of those as well. But yeah, I'll take the feedback because, you know, it's, you know, we got to get it right for everyone.
Sure.
Or as close to making everyone happy as we can.
Yeah.
And, but I think we're going to be real close coming out of the box.
Yeah. Yeah. That's good. Well, let's see what, the last thing had here was the, apprenticeship office, with, some approval, of some money right there.
Yeah, I figured I noticed that hadn't been being done. So I figured I'd kind of start putting that on y'all's form when we have the meeting, because y'all just get lucky because AACSE's yesterday. So it works out. I can get y'all the very next day. So I'm going to start having that on there so y'all can kind of see that, you know, hey, electrical schools are getting money from the CT fund. And just so y'all have an idea of what is being used for the electrical. I'm going to do the same thing for the plumbing as well. I just think it's a good thing to have on there so y'all kind of have an idea, because most of the time y'all are kind of in the dark on that sort of thing.
Sure.
So as you see there, that was approved yesterday for our electrical schools that turned in for CT grants. So a big majority of that really was one school, but it was mainly code books, stuff like that. So it got it up there.
That's cool.
Yeah.
That was NATF.
Okay.
And code books?
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
Another thing, kind of go off of what Lindsay was talking about a minute ago. I hadn't discussed back with him. I did talk to the rest of our people yesterday, Cody and them, you know, talking to them about saying, hey, as soon as we get ours out, we need to get with their IT so we can start getting these, you know, meshed and put together at one point. We have a meeting next Tuesday to go. I'd say it's, as far as I'm concerned, my last walkthrough on this thing for a little bit. I've only been on couple of them so far, but I'm hoping that basically by the end of next week, this thing is going to be shipped out to our five schools that have already agreed, raised their hand to start testing our side of things. They're going to be testing it. We are going to be testing it in-house. From what I've been told, we're going to have to test it a minimum of 5 hours a week. There'll be money coming from us to DIS throughout this process. Right now, we got, you know, basically the money figured out till July, I think June or July. So we're hoping it's not going to take that long at all. So, but they just went ahead and kind of got that all figured out. So, but we'll start doing that 5 hours, 5 hours, I think 5 hours a day or 5 hours a week, something like that, that we in-house will be doing it to go through it. And then, of course, we'll have it sent out to our schools that are going to start, you know, testing it and, you know, and running with it and seeing where it goes. I mean, y'all know how databases are. There's always going to be some hiccups along the way, even after you get them out and you think everything's fine. So, but we'll hopefully at that point, we'll have the biggest part of it worked out, and then we'll just have to tweak it as we go. So I'm really looking forward to it. I think, you know, it's going to help, you know, help the schools. They won't be having to do a bunch of double stuff. They could even, you know, use our system that we will have, you know, for example, a smaller school. This is something that they will actually could even just use as their own personal database and not even have to have their own. They could just use it. You know, because, you know, each school can get in there, have all their students in there, all their different locations, you name it, put all their time in. Their semester reports will just be able to be uploaded. Won't be having to go and enter in each individual person. Y'all have it pulled up on a form. You'll be able to just get it, drag it down to an Excel spreadsheet and shoot it in. So we're hoping this is all going to work out all right, but of course we'll see when we start testing it. You know, and it's also set up for all the different queries that we get asked for, you know, how many apprentices are in, you know, Benton County or whatever. So we run into a lot of questions like that on our end, that either our office or even legislatures want to know. They like knowing where some of their money is kind of going when it comes to their apprenticeship schools and stuff. So I think it, hoping it will be a good thing once we get it out. So we'll kind of go from there. Other than that, everything else is, you know, going as normal right now.
Good. Glad to hear that. We need something going normal.
Yeah. As normal as you can be in 2022.
Yeah. Even, even small things would be nice. That pretty much concludes everything we had on our agenda. Our next meeting date is February the 4th. If that needs to change, certainly let us know. Derek, if there's some other reason that we can't get together on that date, okay. Let's hold off and you keep our options open, but for a face-to-face meeting, you know, March, April, once we get past flu season a little bit, it sure would be nice to get everybody together again after 2 years, and have a face-to-face meeting. It really would be, and be at your new your new location. So, your new old location, I guess. Yeah. Or old new.
Yeah, new location.
We haven't been able to meet there yet. So
down here on the river.
Yeah. Right close to where one of my offices used to be over on Brookwood. Anyway, anyone else have anything to present to the committee? If not, I'll entertain a motion to adjourn.
Make a motion to adjourn.
I'll second.
Needed. Thank you.
All right.
2:04, Derek, was our adjournment time.